And also creating these delegations, you know, creating these delegates and listening to them. And then when something happens, you pass this data to the view. And when the view responds, you also get and pass this to the model. That's a lot of boilerplate that people notice that you can pretty much eliminate a boilerplate with some kind of binder framework that does all that for you. You know, you just say, hey, bind this model with this view, and that's it. Do its job. You don't need to be writing hundreds and hundreds of lines of code to do it. And they started calling this model view view model, which is a variation of MVC. It's because you still have the view, the model layer here, and you would have a view model, which is a specialized version of the model that converts what the model provides with data, actions, and so on, into what the view layer expects and needs. And you will bind them.
It converts the view, the massive view, sorry, the massive model into a more shrinked version for the view.
Yeah, it doesn't need to be a massive model. It could be just like the model is not trying to provide what the view wants. For example, the model may have a date. Let's say you have a model here that has a date object. Let's say the view doesn't know how to render a date. So you need to convert it into a string, right? So the view model will do that translation between what's in the model and what the view needs. So we need to convert this date into actually a, let's say something like this, like January 22, 2021, which is a string, right?
Yeah.
But here is this date here is just a float.
Like, yeah.
Makes sense?
Yes.
And the view can render this, for example. Pretty much the idea. Create a model specific for the view with what the view needs without polluting view logic, presentation logic into the model. Thus, the model can still be used in with other user interfaces. If there's another user interface, you create another representation of that data, another view model, and another view, but the same model still. And you eliminate all the boilerplate between listening, the view events, and then converting all that. No, you just create a view model that will provide the translations, whatever actions the view needs, and the binding will go through some binding mechanism, like, let's say, RxSwift, Combine, or, I don't know, at Microsoft, they created this XAML thing that we would define the binding in XML, and it would automatically work. That was the idea, eliminate boilerplate. But it's still the same concept of three tiers, three layers.